Welcome to the Antarctic Midwinter Broadcast, a special program of greetings for members of the British Antarctic Survey overwintering on that frozen southern continent. I'm Keris Matthews. Now, last year, the BBC invited me to say a few words to you, and I was so taken with the idea that this year, I've stolen their recording equipment so I can present the entire show. So, what shall we expect? Over the next half hour, we'll have music and messages for all 45 of you who are stranded in the snow, keeping four British research stations running until sunshine and supplies return. We've got some surprise guests too, one of whom seems to have lost one of you already.
I believe I'm broadcasting to an audience of 44. Well, I'm sure I've had lower listening figures on some of the shows that I've done. If I'd been given more time on the Radio on Breakfast show, I'm pretty sure I could have got the ratings down to 44. They were certainly heading that way.
Let's get straight on with some messages. And first batch are for the team of eight in the comparatively balmy banana belt of South Georgia at King Edward Point. We raise a pina colada to you with your music request. By Rufus Holmes, and there is no escape until the boat arrives. So you're with me, I have you as my kidnapped.
We've been together too long, like a worn out recording of a favorite song.
This is a message for Lewis Howie in South Georgia. Hi Lewis, it's Mum. Just to say we love you very much, son. It's fantastic to see your photos, and you're making us Dumfriesians a proud bunch. Bagger's missing you. Woof woof! Did you hear him? What was him? Wishing you and all your mates in South Georgia a happy Mother's Day. Have a stolen time, son. Love you. If you like me, getting caught in the rain. If you're not into yoga, if you have half a brain.
This message is for Jamie Coleman. Hi, Jamie.
Hope you're not being frozen out by the cold.
Or carried away by a giant petrel.
Alex and Anna send their love to Liam and Ryan in their own special way.
And Ella says, don't forget to drink.
The cat's decided he likes your bedroom too much to give it up.
So let us know when you're coming home and we'll clear out the cupboard under the stairs.
Midwinter.
For Roger Stillwell. Hi Rog, this is John.
And this is Mum.
I hope all is going well there, and I hope you're not too busy. On the off chance things have settled down a bit, I hope you're not too bored.
Happy day, Rog. Make the most of your second half while you can. Lots of love, good health and luck from Mum and Dad.
Look after yourself and try not to injure yourself. Again.
Bye, Rog.
This is a message from Robbie Scott.
What's up?
We drew the short straw again this year in organising your midwinter message.
We told everybody that we're doing it tonight at the Meet of Mine if they want to have an input. However, we've been waiting here hours and nobody's shown up, so it's just us two again.
Probably a good thing, though, because Dad was disappointed that you've not replied to his emails, and Mum would just say how much she loved you and embarrassed you in front of all your mates.
Oh, I've asked the doctor about that thing you emailed me, and his advice was just to stop rubbing it as much, mate.
Take care, Robbie.
Keep having fun, mate.
Russell Craig, King Edward Point. The days are long and hot, the birds are singing, your dad's cutting the grass twice a day and trying to keep his beard cool. But you wouldn't have any of that.
Hi Russ, we hope you're still enjoying swimming around in boats all day. Working.
You still haven't told me how you're going to bring me a penguin home. Happy birthday next month. Safe and warm. Lots of love, Mum and Dad.
This is a message from Matthew Phillips and his good friend Roy Jordan. Matt, we've been reading your blog religiously and we were really devastated to hear the news of giving up the running. Mate, quite honestly, we could hardly believe it. And we saw the pictures of you and we could believe it all too readily. You're absolutely huge, mate. Absolutely huge. What have you been eating down there? Penguins. Macaroni penguins, mate, by the looks of it. We're looking forward to seeing you, though, mate. Cheers.
So I waited with high hope and she walked in the place. I knew her smile in an instant. Curve of her face. It was my own lovely lady. And she said, oh, it's you.
Richard Duston from Eric and Michael. You're missing out on a good summer here on the coast. The garden's looking good. I can tell you I'm not looking after it. Best wishes from Brenda and Bob, by the way. Guess you'll be getting a bit of skiing done. Hopefully you're still up to the job right now. Oh, boy. We're all
looking forward to seeing you, Bitmer, so you can get some beers in for us.
Take care,
Richard.
Good luck.
This is a message for Dr. Becky Taylor from Nick, Mum, Helen and Gillian.
Hi, Rebecca. I hope you're having a fantastic day with lots of silliness. She and I are sitting in the sunshine, and she is wondering why there aren't more houses. Lots of love, Mum, and...
Hey, Rebecca. How's it going? Just to let you know, I've sold everything you've got in store, apart from the avocado beef donor, which I've saved.
Bonjour.
C'est Hélène.
Et Julien.
Joyeuses fêtes.
Du milieu d'hiver.
À bientôt. My best wishes then go to all at KEP, King Edward Point. Now, another 2,000 kilometres to the southwest, on the Antarctic Peninsula, we come to the UK's largest Antarctic research station, Rothera. Here's someone who knows what it's like to live in cramped conditions away from the world.
Hello, I'm Helen Sharman. I was the first British astronaut in 1991 when I went to the Mir space station. In space, we felt... I can only imagine what it's like wintering out in Antarctica, but I know that real camaraderie of people who, when you're working hard together, regardless of what you're doing, you're one of the team, and the ultimate aim of what you're trying to achieve is such a magnificent thing down there in Antarctica. The light will come at the end of the winter, the warmth will come back, and just as I opened the hatch when I came back to Earth and smelled that fresh air, I wish you all the best of smelling your piece of nice warm air when you finally get into summer air to breathe in. So best wishes to you all.
Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun. And I said, it's alright.
This is a message for John Law on Rothera Base. Hello, my lovely. Happy midwinter. I hope you're enjoying your celebrations. At least it means that spring's on its way now. Just wanted to send love from me, my dad, from Sammy Folkestone. Also from Russ, Rose and Tilly. Nan and Uncle Jim. Take care, love.
This is a message for Emily Davey from Mum, Dad and Fiona. Hi, Emily. Hope you're having a great midwinter's day and that everyone there is having lots of fun. I'm only halfway through now and I'm so happy you're enjoying it. Love you, Em.
Hi, Em. We know you're loving it there. Lots of people over here asking how you're getting on. Happy midwinter.
Bye.
This is a message for Braddy Morell from Mum and Dad. On this midwinter day, we are sure your party will be memorable. We know the next few months will continue to be as enjoyable with exciting new experiences from the work, the landscape and your colleagues, many of whom may well become friends for life. We wish you lots and lots. See you there, April.
For Malcolm Ealy from his mum.
Hi Malcolm, happy Midwinter's Day again.
I hope all the celebrations are going well and that you're all having a great time. I'm having a large G&T, I come with Alfred, so I can make my card and say cheers, enjoy yourself.
This is a message for Louis Georgiadis, chef down at Rothera. Happy Midwinter's, Louis. I bet you've got a great meal planned for everyone today. We are all very proud of you and miss you very much. Keep cooking, keep well, and keep taking those fab photos. Sending you lots and lots of love from all your family and friends in Nottingham. Kalanikta.
Hi, this is a message for Joe Bolton. You tell baby's family all about you, as you are the most exciting friend we have, a real life explorer. We miss you so much and can't wait to have a hug with you and with our son and his gin, although not necessarily in that order. Hope you're having an extra special midwinter and you're looking after yourself. Enjoy the celebration. We love you loads from Anna Richards, family, Josie the dog and all family, especially my mum.
Welcome from Mum, Dad and Henry. We're wishing you well. You are enjoying the work and experience down there.
If anyone enjoying the midwinter festivities, I will be thinking of you on the day.
All the best. Love from Mum, Dad and Henry.
Hey, Hector.
Hi, Hector.
Call the bus, mate.
Hey,
Hi, Hector.
Hello, Hector.
Hi, Hector.
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 Hector, I love you.
Hi, mate. How are the polar bears?
Hi, Hector. It's Mum here. Lots of love.
For Ali Rose.
Hey, Ali. We all say hello, and everyone wants you to know those you love far and near say, Mum is great. Can you hear us? Put
What on the face, you grow?
We've debated your beard and its mask. There's disagreement between Mum and your lass. It makes your mum weep, and she hopes it won't keep. Anya says...
Grow it under your ass.
Oops, that last line won't suit BBC, but we all do completely agree.
Take the sun, well, soon shine, and say...
Have a great time!
In the snow, on the ice, and the sea.
Hi, Saz, Ali here. On behalf of all the UK junior glider pilots, lots of love, and we miss you loads.
Hello, Sazzy, just me, April. I'm really missing you lots, and I can't wait to see you when you get back. I hope you're having the best time.
Hey, Saz, Saz and Hannah. Nice to meet you, I'm really glimmer. Looks like you're having a great time.
Hi, Saz, it's a long time to catch you.
Hope everything's going all right.
I've got some pictures, it looks like it is.
Hello, Sarah. Hope you're enjoying the shorter stay party. It's all uphill from here.
This is a message for Alistair Doherty from Mum.
I hope you're passing the right way. I wish you a happy midwinter stroll.
I'm afraid a whole cobra in wouldn't fit, though I had two eaters to fit. I'm sure at Rotherham you'll potty all night, and I hope that tomorrow you'll feel all right. Also, during midwinter you find yourself fitting, don't forget to get on with your knitting. Tons of love to you, darling, from all of us here.
Message is from Robert Kennedy. Happy midwinter, Robert. The next 30 seconds are filled with love and warm wishes from all your family and friends in Dublin and Smyrna. We wish you and all the team in Madrid a very happy. I can't believe it's midwinter already. Robert, we all love you and see, but we know you're having a fantastic result here, and we can't wait to see you in years' time. Get the love for Celine.
To David Routledge from Mum. Happy midwinter. Enjoy the celebrations. Try and stay on your feet. Lynn hopes you enjoy opening your presents this year. Best wishes to you all. Love from all at home.
Bye.
A message for Kate Stanton from her parents.
Although we miss seeing your smiling face and having you near,
we're proud you're living your dream.
An exciting and adventurous dream.
We wish we could come and see the beauty of the wonder for ourselves.
But only for a few days.
Continue to have a wonderful time.
Live it fully.
Take care of yourself.
We'll be waiting for you in a new home.
When the ice is alive with the sounds of cracking,
with the songs that are sung
for a million years,
then the sun will shine again. We love you, girl.
Messages for my amazing son, Matt Bell, halfway through his first winter. Lots of love from me, your mum, and all the sisters and the family. Just make it a wonderful, wonderful midwinter day, wishing you lots of fun. We love you and miss you. Be safe.
This message is for Ben Robinson from the Robinson and Headley Base Camp. Ben, we are very proud of you, and we know you are working very hard. We'd just like to see you keep up the hard work. We're very proud of you. We also said that you're having a fantastic time with a great bunch of people. It's going to be the time of your life. Have a merry midwinter. All our love, Dad. We'll think of that.
The message is for Octavian Carp, and it's from his mother and his daughter. We love you very much. Keep healthy and in a good shape. We are waiting to see you back at home.
For Adam Burke and Carol Burke.
Hello, Adam. Hope you have a great midwinter day and enjoy the celebration.
Lots of love from Mum, Dad, Ian, Lee, Emma and Jack.
This is a message to Craig Nelson on Rotherham from Mumbai. Today is a double celebration. Not only is it midwinter, but it's also your 29th birthday. You certainly won't forget where you were in the evening of this birthday, will you? We hope you have a wonderful day today. Continue to keep yourself safe, and we love and miss you very much. And by the way, Dad says, up the borough.
Hi, Callum. Just wanted to say we love you lots, and here's a wee message from all the family.
Happy birthday, Callum. Have a great day.
Wish you loads, lots of love. Dixie and Dashie are missing your discipline, pal.
Hope you're cooking some really good meals down there, pals.
Hope your midwinter celebrations go well.
Happy birthday, awesome. I hope you enjoy the rest of your trip to Granny.
Good luck, Callum. Keep coming home.
Eva and Vivian are looking forward to seeing your Uncle Callum again.
Bye! Bye. Bye.
And the Beatles are right. The sun is, I mean, eventually that is. It's as dark as it will get in Antarctica now. Midday skies will soon be getting brighter. And in a week or two, there will be a chance of sunrise. Now may I add my own best wishes to all at Rotherham, especially Craig Nelson and Callum Watt, who shall have birthday this midwinter's day. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Craig and Callum. Happy birthday to you. Now then, I just said we share a birthday this midwinter's day, and it seems odd to say in winter when it's glorious here. Yes, I'm going to rub it in. People are out, lots of flesh in Soho Square. We've also got an email for Rotherham Red by Adam Bradley.
This is a message for Christopher Mervyn. Hi, Christopher. Wishing you and all your colleagues at Rotherham Research Station a happy midwinter's day. I imagine that you are looking forward to some lighter, sunnier and warmer days. I hope that you enjoyed your special meal today and that you ate your sprouts. Aha, I even get to say that even though we're thousands of miles apart. We're all looking forward to you coming home next year. Molly is going to hide your passport when you get back. Lots of love always from Mum, Dad, Claire, David, Millie, Nana, Molly, Theo, Austin and, of course, our latest member of our family, the little miracle, Jensen.
Adam Bradley, you're now station leader for the Halley Research Station. But I think you've overwintered yourself at Rotherham. What happens on Midwinter's Day?
Midwinter's Day is brilliant. It starts off first thing in the morning with the winter station leader making breakfast for everyone, properly, even if they're very good serving it to them in their bunks. And then it's a slow start, no work that day. You'll have a meal early in the afternoon and then probably get out for a bit of a walk around. There may even be a bit of streaking, a bit of naked activity in the snow, and then raucous party going on in the evening. There's always the traditional viewing of the John Carpenter film, The Thing, as well. That's a classic way to spend a bit of midwinter time.
This is the Antarctic Midwinter Broadcast, coming to you on shortwave from the BBC World Service in London. Here's Dr. Jane Francis, Director of the British Antarctic Survey, with a message to you all.
Hello for me and everybody here at the British Antarctic Survey in Cambridge. At the end of another really busy year, every year is busy. The big things that we've had happening in this past year, of course, everything to do with the ship, and the ship now has a name, and a big, big project that will carry on into the future, of course, it's a moving Halley station across to the other side of that notorious crack. And we have some really big science programs going on in the field, especially on the Filchner ice shelf, trying to understand whether the ice shelf is stable or whether it's succumbing to climate change and melting from below. So we're all really busy here. And we'll all be thinking of you as we eat our barbecue and burgers in the sun here in Cambridge after the fun run, which is always great fun here in Cambridge on Midwinter's Day. So happy midwinter to you all. We'll all be thinking of you down there in the deep, cold, dark south.
Jane Francis. Now further south still to the Halley Base, where the sun won't rise for another 7 weeks and it's pushing minus 40. Halley 6, the previous 5 bases have been abandoned to the ice, looks like an alien outpost with its line of futuristic accommodation and science pods. Here's a message for you from one of my colleagues here at the BBC. He loves air drumming. I wonder if he's air drumming now.
Hey there, Antarctic chums. International playboy celebrity DJ Mark Radcliffe here. Hi to you in your space-age pods in the White House. I'm actually quite jealous. I watched the programme with that weatherman, Peter Gibbs, and he did that about your base and lifestyle, and kind of envy you the wilderness experience. The programme probably got a bit scientific for me. I did fail physics O-level, after all. I revised the night before by watching Star Trek, and nothing on transporter beams came up that day, so it was just bad luck, really. Anyway, it's a privilege to be able to say hi, and to thank you for the work you continue to do whilst battling the elements. Adios, amigos. Enjoy the midwinter.
Thank you, Mark Radcliffe. Now, John Eager has been station leader for Halley and has overwintered there, though now he's based in Cambridge. As he points out, Halley is not actually on the solid ground of Antarctica at all. Hold tight. There's a crack in the ice.
Now Halley sits on the Brunt Ice Shelf, which is about 150 metres thick and floats on the Weddell Sea there. At the moment, we're getting ready to move the station. We're looking to move it about 24 kilometres further towards the Antarctic continent itself, to move away from the crack that's developing about 7 kilometres from the station. But the crack's very slow moving at the moment. It's moving about 1.7 kilometres a year. It's not going to get to the station for the next few years, but what it means is we can elongate the life of the station by keeping it warm.
Panic. Let's hope we don't freeze.
float away before then.
Anyway, let's carry on. It's Christmas time, isn't it? In the meantime,
you're a first. Here's Roxanne from the police as we listen to the messages for this year's team at Halley.
Victoria Stone from Mum, Dad, Kingsley and Bentley. Midwinter, Aurora dancing lights with winter dark days and nights. At the South Pole, where you discovered the ozone hole. From Shackleton and Scott, who gave it their best shot, to your Halley ice shelf, which gives scientific wealth. Antarctic survey, please.
These messages from Matt Etheridge down at Halley.
Hi, Matt. Happy midwinter day. Hope you're having a really good party down there. Don't worry, the sun will be up soon, and it's probably raining in Cumbria anyway. Missing you lots here. Love you.
Mum, Dad, Joe and Laura calling. Hoping that the tracks that you leave in the snow always lead you safely home. That the snow bridges always bear your weight, and that you enjoy the challenges yet to come. And always remember to not make tea with yellow snow. Have a great big winter party.
It's from Greg Lawson. Have a great day, son.
Hi Greg, happy midwinter day. Missing you loads, but we're almost happy. Okay, see you soon. Love you.
Love you, Greg. Mom.
Hello, David Wright at Holly Lewis. Pete and Hannah send their love. Happy midwinter's day.
Try not to sacrifice anyone. Evidence suggests the sun will probably come up again without bloodshed.
I'm missing you loads.
Granny was asking after Pablo and his adventures, and all the grandparents send their love.
Love from everyone at last.
And Dad and Howie.
A message for Dr. Jessica Walkup from Mum, Dave and family.
Hello, Jessie Bob.
Hope you're all enjoying your midwinter celebrations. We're all thinking about you, always are. Looking forward to a great big hug. Keep warm, keep well, and remember we're all so proud of you. And to be honest, a little jealous of your great big adventure. You should all be incredibly proud of what you're doing down there. Love you lot.
Hi, Mum. This year your midwinter greetings come from...
Hi, Maya.
Kasia.
And Sanders. We hope you're enjoying your long nap. We're sure you're getting plenty of sleep as usual.
Meanwhile, nights are getting shorter here in Ireland. We even got a few beams of sunshine lately, which, as you know, is not always given.
Looking forward to see you back.
We miss you!
Well, you know I don't.
Take care.
Hello, this is a message for Pitabu Almeida. He's at Halley Function, and I've been working at British Antarctic Alpha in the winter, so I'd like to give a message in Portuguese. Ricardo, tivete muito, é bem-vindo, e Portugal vai um grande abraço com saudades, é? Continuação do bom grande trabalho.
Hey, Amy, we send warm and Alpine greetings to you down there in the cold and dark. Enjoy your midwinter bash. I really miss you.
Much love from your mum. Hi, Amy, so that's all it is for the second half. Many kisses and lots of love. Take care.
Hi, Amy. Happy midwinter from Duncan and...
Okay.
And...
Happy midwinter, Amy. Let me know.
This message is still coming from Mum, Dad, Nicholas, Mummy, Grandad, and all your family and friends. Wishing you a happy midwinter day 2016. Hope all the vehicles and machinery are being kind to you in your hometown this winter. Stay safe, keep warm, and make the most of this fantastic experience. We will miss you and look forward to seeing you next year.
Richard and Mum, Halley. This is Mother Goose. Coniston.
All the trees have come out in all the wonderful colours of green.
The mountains are looking fabulous
and they're missing you running up them.
Potatoes and veggies in the allotment could do with your help with the digging and weeding.
But by the time you get there, I will have done the farmyard, a big mag bash with CMA. Rock bands, hairy leather clad bikers, yippee! And I'm pouring tea in the Holy Joke.
Love you. Signing off, Mother Goose. God bless.
This message is for Ross Sanders and it's from his mum who's reading it and his dad who has written the poem. And the poem is, it's a long, long time till dawn, cold as hell, deserts of ice, aurora dancing and a front haunting. crystal stars, cold, wind, blizzard, a haunting.
Eternal diamond, please come back. It's a long, long time till dawn.
It's a message for Stuart's
attorney.
Happy midwinter day, darling. Hope you're having a great day. But most importantly...
Happy birthday, Stuart. Hope you're having a good time.
All our love.
And happy birthday to her. It's 28 today. And now a message from someone who doesn't seem to know his love from the South.
Hello, this is Angela Sophia here, and I'm meeting everyone down there at the North Pole, or I don't know which one it is, I don't really know where you are, but I know it's cold, and it's Christmas already, even though it's sundown. I don't really know. Anyway, have a lovely Christmas. I'll be thinking of you while I drink my white lightning. Okay, bye.
Angelos Epicimou, also known as Dan Skinner. Weirdly requested by the team of four on Bird Island. Quackers they are. A more understandable request is for Mr. Blue Sky from ELO.
To Timothy Morley, Bird Island. From Mum and Dad. Just to say, we miss you very much and hope you're having a really good time down on Bird Island. Keep thinking of you, and Miss Laura sends her love. Look after yourself. Love, Mum and Dad.
This is the James Robin from Bird Island, from Mum, Dad and Eloise. We hope you enjoy all your good celebrations. Love, all about it, and seeing the photos. Have a great day. Love from all the family.
Hi, Jane from Bird Island. It's Catherine. I hope you're having a really happy Midwinter celebration, preferably eating a lot of chocolate. However, small word of advice for the cold. Remember your scarf.
Hi, Lucy. It's Russell and the boys wishing you a
happy midwinter.
Everyone in the family sends you all their love, and we're all so proud of you.
It's an incredible thing to do and must be an amazing experience.
I hope your winter is going well, and with the days getting longer, you'll have lots to look forward to. I hope polar bears having fun.
Here's Edie.
Why can't you share a pterodactyl go to the bathroom?
This message is for Ian's story on Bird Island from Caprice Schultz in Salt Lake City, Utah. Stop having so much fun and come back. Mostly kidding. Lots of love to Chris.
Finally, here's someone who has put real thought into a fitting tribute to you all.
Hello, British Antarctic Survey. It's Greg Davis here. I hope you're having a wonderful midwinter celebration. I had a little think about a fitting tribute, and I've decided I'm going to eat an entire family tub of ice cream on your behalf. You're welcome. Have a great time.
Now, I would absolutely adore to be there with you, enjoying this midwinter celebration. But alas, we can't be with you, although our thoughts are all with you today. But before we party on into that long good night, it's goodbye from me, Keris Matthews, and all our friends in Cambridge and at the BBC World Service in London. And we all want to wish you a happy midwinter. Now, I get to leave you with my own music request, one that leaves a smile to whoever gets to hear it. It's Joseph Spence. And his version, a very special version of Santa Claus. The Antarctic Midwinter Broadcast was produced by Martin Redfern, researched by Anna Moran, Boston Media Production for BBC World Service. Adios.